Hello everybody, in this video we will just discuss a nested if control statement in Python. Okay, so this is the syntax of nested if. See, nested if means if we use if within if, then it is called as nested if. Okay, if you look at this particular syntax, see, this is outer if, and in the body of this if I have used one if else. So this if will be inner if and this is outer if, and this else is of this if. Yeah, this else will be of outer if, while in outer else also there is one more pair of if else. Okay, so this if is within this if and this if is within this else. So here there is a if within if. So this particular concept is called as nested if. Okay, now how this syntax will be executed by Python interpreter is, see, in the body of this if I have written this statement, statement 1. So when statement 1 is executed, when both condition, outer if condition as well as this inner if condition, both conditions are true, then statement 1 will be executed. Okay, when statement 2 will be executed, when, see, first condition is true, in that case only control will come inside. But here in the body of this outer if, we have mentioned else. Okay, and this else will be of this inner if. So when control will come here on this else, when this outer condition is true and this inner condition is false. Okay, so statement 2 is executed when outer condition is true and inner condition is false. Okay, when statement 3 is executed, see, what is the position of statement 3? Here statement 3 we have written in if, and this if is in this else. Now when control will come here on this else, when this condition is false. Now when outer condition is false and this inner condition is true, at that time statement 3 will be executed. Okay, and finally when statement 4 will be executed, when outer condition is false, then control will come on this else. And when this condition is false, then again control will come on this else. So statement 4 will be executed when both outer and inner conditions are false. Okay, so statement 1, when both conditions are true. Statement 2, outer true, inner false. Then statement 3, outer false, inner true. And statement 4, both false. Okay, now I want to discuss one program where we will use this nested if syntax. Okay, suppose I want to write this program. I want to write a program to find largest number when three distinct numbers are given. Okay, when three numbers are given, then we have to find largest number. Okay, let us assume that we store three number in three variables, n1, n2 and n3. Okay, now what is the logic of this program? See, this is logic. When we can say that n1 is largest, n1 is largest when n1 is greater than n2 and obviously when n1 is greater than n3. So to make this conclusion that n1 is largest, we have to check how many conditions? We have to check two conditions. When both n1 and when n1 is greater than n2 and when n1 is greater than n3, in that case we can say that n1 is largest. Okay, now when n3 is largest, when n1 is greater than n2 and n1 is greater than n3, n1 is less than n3, at that time n3 largest. Similarly, when n2 largest, so n1 less than n2 and n2 greater than n3, in that case n2 largest. Okay, and one more condition I have mentioned here for making a conclusion, like n3 is largest. Okay, now we have to place all these conditions in this syntax, in the nested if-else syntax. Okay, now here if I want to write a statement like n1 largest, so if n1 is largest, then these two conditions must be true. So what are the conditions? N1 greater than n2 and n1 must be greater than n3, and then in that case here we can write n1 is largest. Now let us write program directly. Okay, so how many variables we will require? We will require three variables. Okay, so first one, n1. Okay, how to take input we have already discussed. Let us take input of type integer and call input function. Here we have to display message like enter value n1. Okay, so this is how we can take value of n1. So in the same way we can take value of n2 and n3 as well. You can copy and paste same statement. Okay, so here just change variable name n2 and then n3. Okay, now here we have taken value of n1, n2 and n3. Now we have to follow this syntax. Okay, and for that we have to use this logic. Okay, now initially what I said, I want to write here at this position, I want to write statement like n1 largest. But for making this conclusion, what I said, and for deciding n1 is largest, I want to check, we have to check two conditions, that is n1 must be greater than n2 and n1 must be greater than n3. Okay, so here let us write this program using nested if. So if we are using nested if, then we have to use this syntax. So initially in front of if we have to write condition. So let us write condition here, n1 greater than n2, okay, colon. According to syntax, we have to give colon. And now we have to use nested if, means within this if, we have to use one more if. Okay, and then in front of that if also, we have to write one more condition. So n1 greater than n3, okay. Now, when control will come here on this statement, here let us write statement as print n1 is largest. Okay, now when control will come here on this statement, when both these conditions are true, remember when, what I said, when statement 1 will be executed, when both conditions are true, and when both conditions are true, we know that n1 is largest. So I have just tried to insert our logic in this nested if else syntax. Okay, now initially according to nested if else syntax, here we have to write else. Now this else will be of which if? This else will be of this inner if. So when this else will be executed, when this condition is true, that is n1 is greater than n2, but this condition is false, n1 greater than n3 is false, means what? N1 greater than n3 is false means n1 is less than n3. So when control will come here, when n1 is greater than n2 and n1 is less than n3. Okay, so here see, in the logic, when n1 is greater than n2 and n1 is less than n3, at that time which number is largest number? N3 is largest number. So here we can print statement as n3 is largest. Okay, now after writing this else, now we have to write else for this outer if. So where to write? We have to write it at this point. Okay, remember, this if and this else must be at same vertically, at same point, must get started at same point vertically. Similarly, this if and this else must be vertically get start at same point. Okay, now in the body of this else we have to write one more if. Okay, now see, when control will come here on this if, when this condition is false, this condition is false, at that time control will come here on this else. So n1 greater than n2 is false, means what? N1 is less than n2. Okay, n1 is less than n2, and if n2 is greater than n3, in that case, so here if I write condition like n2 is greater than n3, if this is the case, okay, if this is the case, then see, when this statement will be executed, when this statement will be executed, when this condition is false and this condition is true. So this condition is false, n1 greater than n2 is false, means what? N1 less than n2, and this condition is true, that is n2 greater than n3, means we are having two conditions, n1 less than n2 and n2 greater than n3. So according to our logic, n1 less than n2 and n2 greater than n3, at that time which number is largest? N2 is largest. So here what we have to write? We have to write n2 is largest. Okay, and finally now we have to write else, and this else will be of which if? This else will be of this inner if. Now when this else will be executed, when this condition is false, at that time control will be on this else, and when this condition is false, at that time control will be on this inner else. So both conditions are false, that is n1 greater than n2 false, means n1 is less than n2. Okay, and n2 greater than n3 is false, means n2 less than n3. Okay, means n1 less than n2 and n2 less than n3. According to our logic, n1 less than n2 and n2 less than n3. At that time, which number is largest? That is n3 is largest. So here, we can print message as n3 is largest. Okay, so I hope you are getting this point. You have to just remember flow here, when which statement will be executed. Okay, so let us execute this program. So initially just asking for value of n1, so I am providing value of n1 as 15, then asking for value of n2. Okay, so actually it has to display n2, but we have to copy and paste that statement. So it is just printing n3 is largest. So let me change this here. It has to display message as enter value of n2 and then value of n. So here you can give, okay, so that proper same statement. Now let us once again execute this program. Okay, asking for value of n1, so I am providing value of n1 as 15, value of n2 as suppose 10, and value of n3 as 25. So in this case it has to display message as n3 largest. See here, we are getting message as n3 largest. So how this code is executing? N1 15, n2 10, and n3 25. So n1 greater than n2, so this condition is true in this case, 15 greater than 10. Okay, then control will come inside. So here n1 we are comparing with n3. So 15 greater than 25, this condition is false. So this condition true, this condition is false. Means control will be on this else and it will just display message as n3 is largest. Accordingly, this code will be executed. So I hope you are getting this point. So that's all for this video. Stay tuned for further updates. Thank you.